Boxing champion Terence Crawford is about to take the podium right here in the full fight press conference.
Hey Ray,
there he is, champion of the world of his hometown, Terence Crawford. Questions, please.
Who's next?
My manager, promoters, handlers, it's up to them.
What do you think
of
this? What
will
you fight?
Well, I think my boxing ability will want me to fight tonight, you know. Fight my fight. Moving, my jab, my movements, you know, my timing.
Ray said that your timing was hard for him to adjust to. Is that kind of the game plan going in, just to be able to keep him out of a rhythm so he never got a chance to do the offensive?
The game plan was to catch him with the jab, you know, establish my jab from the get-go, you know, that way he won't think he was going to walk me down or, you know, those sorts of things. So we want to establish the jab and get a rhythm from the jump. You felt like I did too.
Darren.
Okay.
We've seen the puncher, we've seen the boxer, now we've seen the entertainer. I saw a little devilish grin at the end of round 11. Can you explain the smile?
I was feeling good. I was having fun, man. You know, I was ready for 15 more rounds. Well, not 15, but 15 rounds. I was just ready, you know. I was motivated. I was having fun, man.
Obviously, you've made a name for yourself at 135. Everybody knows you want to go to 140. Why leave when you're on top right now? You're dominating 135. Why leave?
Well, it's something that, you know, we've been discussing for a minute. I've been at 135, 132 since I was 17, since I was 16. You know, I'm 27 now. So I just think it's that time.
Obviously, Terence, this caps a pretty big year for you. You know, you went from not being a champion to being a champion to the big fight that you had here in June to your performance tonight. I know it's right after the fact, but can you kind of put in perspective what you were able to accomplish in the ring this year and what you think it means in the sport?
Well, I think I accomplished a lot in a short period of time. You know, being that I went over to Scotland to beat Ricky Burns, to come back in the fight. You know, Olympic gold medalist and Gamboa. Then turn back around and fight the regular hard fight, Beltran. You know, I feel like this year was a great year.
You think it's the fight of the year?
Most definitely.
Is it a lot of pressure to have thousands and thousands of fans cheer for you and you have to perform? What's it like for you to walk in the ring and have the whole arena there for you, just for you?
I kind of block them out, you know, so I stay focused. You know, I know a lot of people know me and they be reaching out and they probably realize I don't pay them no attention. I just keep them pushing, you know what I mean? That's because I'm not trying to worry about the crowd. I'm not trying to get in the crowd. I got a job to do. So I'm not, you know, too much focused on the crowd. I'm focused on the job at hand.
With Manny Pacquiao maybe wanting to go to 140, you moving up to 140, what about you and Manny? What do you think about it?
That's all talk. You know, I let my managers, you know, my coaches and my team handle that if that day ever comes.
With all the love that you get in Omaha, would you ever fight, or when's the next time, or what would take make you fight outside of Omaha again?
Well, that's nothing that's in my hands. You know, I've been fighting all over since day one. You know, this is only two fights here. You know, I'm 25-0, so that tells you something that I'm not saying I wouldn't fight somewhere else.
With the crowd turnout, it was incredible, and I felt like that could transcend to much more for Nebraska and for yourself. Do you feel like there's something, like what would it take for the next one to be away from here?
I don't know. I leave that to my handlers, you know, Tyrone, my managers, Brian McIntyre and Cameron Duncan, and, you know, my coaches, and they gonna all sit down and see what's the best move for Terence, Tim Crawford.
How does it feel to have defended your title twice in your hometown?
It was great. You know, after the win, you know, you got all your friends, family, everybody here to see you, and you don't got to go too far. You don't got to worry about getting on those planes or staying in a hotel. Everything is everything. You know, it's no place like home.
Go ahead.